Okay, so this is of typical supply chain management stages can be set as. Now, all these things, remember one thing, we are speaking it in general terms. Now, we are not going to any specific thing here. That is to tell, generally, these stages would be there in the supply chain. Now, depending upon the company and depending upon the product or the service that is being passed down in the supply chain, there might be difference in the stages, or there might be more stage for some of the supply chain. It could be less stage. Now, the same thing in the participants of the supply chain management as well. Depending upon the situation, there might be difference. So, these are the things how generally it would be. Now, if at all tomorrow you get a question as to, wherein which they would ask you to specifically speak about a supply chain of one company, you should be able to tell about that. Or they might ask you all a hypothetical situation wherein which they might ask you all to come up with your own organization and draw a supply chain. So these are some of the cases that can possibly happen. It is not that it would happen, it's just an idea, might be possibly it can happen. Now, speaking about the stages of supply chain. Now, we were speaking regarding this cooperation, coordination, risk, and reward in the supply chain. So, this cooperation among the channel members is always very much necessary for the effectiveness of supply chain management. Now, this cooperation starts with joint planning and it shall definitely ends with joint control activities, wherein all such activities it tries to analyze performance or the things that are being done by the supply chain members. Now, all this evaluation of the performance that happens in the supply chain. Now, it happens at several management levels and it also involves cross-functional coordination across the channel and the channel members or the channel participants. Now, when we speak theoretically, we speak a lot about this cooperation, coordination, the rewards are to be shared equally, risk are to be, shared equally along the continuum. But then when practical things happens, getting people to cooperate is the most difficult part of a supply chain management. Now, even when it may produce, superior mutual outcomes, people are generally concerned about them and they would like to promote their individual objectives, and cooperation limits the freedom of firms to act in their own interest. So, when performing similar or complementary activities, that is to tell, coordination we have to bring in. But then when there are lot of participants, each participant will be having their own objective as to what is that they want to fulfill. Now, these objectives definitely would be such that it might come in the way of the objective of the other participant. So, coordination in supply chain, or for that matter, coordination anywhere, It shall always ask for some of the things that are to be given away from each of the participant. So, and that is the only way of cooperation or coordination can be brought in. Now, a supply chain succeeds if all members of the supply chain have the same goal and the same focus on serving customer and establishing the same goal and the same focus among the chain members. This means that all the participants, all the members, they are working towards a form of policy integration. So most organizations, they go through these four steps that have been mentioned. These four steps of supply chain policy integration. So stage one. Now stage one, we have named it as baseline case. So this represents the base activity of the organization. So in the first stage, the functions of supply chain is a fragmented operation within each company. That is to tell, stage one, here all the decisions that would be taken would be different for all the participants that are involved. It is fragmented to the internal decisions that are to be taken individually by the companies. And this particular stage one, now it is based on the traditional concepts of business, and because of that, it is always characterized by what we call as staged inventories and independent and incompatible control system and procedures and functional segregation of all the activities. Now do not go breaking your head behind these complex words that are being said. Now yes, the thing with using these difficult words is that, see, you people as a managers, you'll have to learn how managers speak, okay? And there is a way how things happen. Now, in simple words, how layman understands, that is actually fine. But you people having taken this course, you know some different words. Now, in simple, if I have to tell whatever I said, it simply means that stage one is such that wherein the decisions that are to be taken, here there shall be no any other parties involved. Each individual firm have to decide what does it wants to happen when it enters the supply chain. That is all about stage one, wherein which we used words such as inventories, incompatible control system, procedures, functional segregation. This is the management language that we normally speak. When you go through textbooks again and again, or when you go through the study material, you should be able to know all these words. So you'll be fine, but then you'll have to put a little bit effort in reading textbooks so that you can understand all these words. So first stage, it is all about the fact that, you know, it is a functional, you know, functional operation and also fragmented one. Fragmented speaks about it has been divided into many, and each one will be having their own. And it happens within the individual company. That's it in the stage one or the baseline case. Now, stage two is nothing but it speaks about, or it speaks all about the internal integration that has to happen. So it definitely starts with the internal integration. Now it begins with pointing a focus on, you know, cost reduction rather than performance improvement. And the main characteristic of stage 2 is that there is an emphasis on the internal trade-offs and also the reactive customer service. Now here, stage 1, each of the decision was different for each of them. Here there is integration, or they are trying to bring cooperation among the departments of the firms. So here they give more attention to cutting cost rather than satisfaction of the customer. The trade-offs between the department is all that is being done under stage 2. Okay. Now, stage 3. What happens in stage 3? Under stage 3, it is cooperation integration. Now, this is the stage when the organization attains internal cooperation integration. Now, this particular stage, here there is full and total visibility of the purchasing through distribution, or maybe medium term planning, the tactical focus of the organization, or even the emphasis or the importance given for the efficiency. Now, here in this stage, there shall be an extended use of electronic support for linkages and also a continued reactive approach to customers. So what happens under stage 3? There is total internal corporate integration, and whatever happens, or there shall be full visibility of purchasing through distribution, or things such as medium term planning, or tactical focus, or giving importance for efficiency, and even the extended use of electronic supports for linkages. So that is the stage 3 of supply chain management. Now stage 4, this is all about the strategic focus. Now the organization, it achieves supply chain integration by extending the scope or the area of the supply chain outside the company, so that the suppliers and even the customer are brought here. Now see, up until stage 3, all the things that happens would be within one industrial organization or one business firm. So it is in the stage 3, the outsiders or the other participants of the supply chain shall be brought into action. So it is in the stage 4 that there is integration of the activities or the efforts from the side of all the supplier and also the customer. So this is the stages of supply chain management. First, the base activity had to be set. Second, internal integration. Third one, there should be corporate integration, where it speaks about strategies a lot, and also how technology can be involved in making things better. And in the fourth stage, all the participants are included. Now, undoubtedly, all the firms, they go through these four stages. Ultimately, policy integration is made possible by the supply chain members who are, you know, trying to be compatible with the cultures and also the management techniques. So when these four stages happen, what we call as collaboration. So this collaboration takes place. And what is this collaboration, by the way? Now, collaboration takes place when two or more independent companies, they try to work together, and in working together, they plan and execute supply chain operations here in specific with greater success than when they are acting in isolation. That is what collaboration here is all about. That is to tell, two is better than one. But then, bringing this collaboration or this coordination, cooperation, this is not an easy task. This is never an easy task. And it shall always require, sustained effort, always, through cross-functional teams and in-plant supplier, personnel and third-party service provider. Now, speaking about all these things, you know, firms that have reached stage 4, they proceed to build up a series of partnership, and these partnership definitely will be successful partnership which aim to integrate supply chain policy to avoid redundancy and overlap, and also while seeking a level of cooperation which allows participant to be more effective at lower cost levels. Now, the organization should always select a small number of partners so that there can be easy facilitation of coordination and cooperation. Now, we can tell that a company has an effective supply chain management when all the partners, they are able to build and maintain long-term relationships where the relationship time horizons maybe extends beyond the life of the contact, perhaps indefinitely. So, this supply chain management extends the supply chain philosophy across all members of the chain. But how does it? Now, it does this particular work by bringing together, or what we call as integrating both behavior and process, and by sharing information, and by planning in collaboration with each other, by sharing the risk and rewards, by having cooperation, by having goal sharing and partnership. That is how the operations in the supply chain can be streamlined, and that is how the profitability of all the members in the supply chain can be increased. Now, the things that what is necessary for supply chain to work effectively is nothing but, first one is there should be an integrated behavior and process. Should be a very good system of sharing information to and fro. There should always be collaboration in planning with one another. They should have the system of sharing both risk and rewards. And there should be cooperation. There should be partnership. And these are some of the ways how supply chain can be maintained effectively. And they also tell that it can be effective when the supply chain management participants have this collaboration for a long term, for a long time horizon. And they also tell what is this long term horizon. Long time horizon can be such that it goes beyond the life of the partner themselves. So, we can take the example of two different companies. These two companies who have been the first ones or the pioneers in supply chain management. Now, those two companies are one is Dell and one is Walmart. Now, these are the two companies that we normally take to explain a supply chain because they were the ones to bring in this concept of supply chain. Okay, now you know what Dell is into, you know what Walmart is into. I guess I need not tell about that once again. Now, Dell is into electronics, Walmart is into retailing. Now, these two companies, they throw light on some of the most successful examples of this, what we call as effective supply chain management. Now, why that we give example of these two companies? Because these were some of the companies which were able to create a world-class supply chain. Not only they came up with this, you know, best possible way of moving goods from supplier to ultimate consumer, but then their supply chains were such that these supply chains were able to tackle the what we discussed earlier called as Foster's effect. Okay. Now, speaking about this, you have two different types of supply chain. One is pull order and one is push. Each of that in the coming classes we shall see in detail. But now just concentrate on the example. Now, this Dell company, it has been a pioneer in build to order, or what we call as pull cycle. That is, now pull cycle is the one which reduces, here there would be things such as reducing forecasting based on demand uncertainty. Whereas Walmart has been pioneer in the use of information flow to reduce demand uncertainty. So Dell Computers builds to order, that is customer order initiates manufacturing at Dell. Dell does not have retailers, wholesalers or distributors in the supply chain. While other computer companies, they normally stock a month of inventory. Whereas Dell carries only a few days worth of stock. Now Dell inventory is such that it plans orders and signals suppliers every 2 hours. And because of this, it enables it to manufacture and deliver exactly what its customer want. Now, in fact, many of the components are delivered to Dell within a few hours of assembly and it is normally shipped to customer. Now, we spoke about one more, that is Walmart. Now, the success of the Walmart, now it is drawn from new technologies combined with, new ways of doing business. Now, it has used the power of information flow to create a global chain which has been designed down to the last atom of efficiency, we can call it as. Now, all the different technologies or the IT or these digital things, all this combined, okay, or the what we call as automated replenishment, and even the smooth functioning of the Walmart supply chain, it depends upon the reliable connectivity between the stores, the centralized database, and the distribution centers. Now the Walmart network, it connects more than 2,400 stores, 100 distribution centers worldwide, and 950,000 Walmart associates. Now this particular data is taken from the year when the particular textbook has been published. Now there might definitely be an increase in all these things. So this was the stages of supply chain management. Okay. After this, what we have is the success of supply chain. Now, how does we can have success in supply chain? Now, if you see this particular slide, the what has been mentioned in diagram is what a integrated supply chain management is all about. It includes all these things, that is purchasing or supplier partnering, inventory management and control, demand and lead time management, materials management, manufacturing, remanufacturing assembly, storage and transportation, order fulfillment, customer analysis. All these different disciplines put together is nothing but integrated supply chain management. Now, having spoken this, let us come back to the success of supply chain. Now, what do you think? How does the success of a or on what does the success of a supply chain is based all on? Now, the success of supply chain is based on, you know, their ability to deliver superior cost, quality, delivery, and also technological performance. Now, all this with the process, it tries to link between the participants are very much important for the success of the chain. And it is also necessary to appreciate the fact that in order to operate a successful supply chain, one has to have the clear understanding of intra-organizational and also inter-organization supply chain. Now, whenever organization does not take into consideration this intra-organizational links or inter-organization links, or also that if they try to, you know, take too much time to evolve intra-organizational process, now that is when it generally becomes too late for supply chain to succeed. So there are more failures in supply chain management as we observe than the success. So normally this success supply chain management, it is evolved by bringing together or integrating three key flows between the different stages across the boundaries of the companies. That is, we had already discussed about this, the three key factors. That is product or materials flow, the flow of information, and the funds. So what is this product or material? Now obviously, or this goes without telling that, now this is the product or the materials is the most visible part of any supply chain. Now physically, the flow manifests itself in the form of either goods or services from the place of origin to the place of consumption. Now, this particular stage is also called as value flow. Now, goods and services follows, or goods and service flows follows a similar sequence. Now, we can try to elaborate it more with the help of an example. Now, what we call as goods flow. Now, when we tell product, it is nothing but both goods and service. So, this goods flow, it constitutes raw materials. Now, this raw materials, it also includes the materials which are being transported. It also includes work in process. Now, it also includes finished goods, it also includes space, it also includes reverse flows which might happen due to returns, it also includes rework or recycling of the goods. So, the vendor side of this flow is called as upstream and flows towards the customer, which is referred to as downstream. Now, what is upstream? Upstream and downstream, you might have heard these words in with the flow of a river. So, where the supplier sends or from where it the place of origin, it is called as upstream, and the place of consumption, it is called as downstream. Now, the next one here is flow of information. What is this? Now, here is what we tell that the information flows along the various partners who are present in supply chain to cooperate and coordinate their long-term plans and to control the day-to-day flow of goods and also materials that are necessary in the supply chain. Now, this information flow, now it shall always include the information that flows from vendor to the customer and also all those information which is passed back from the customer back to the vendor. So, whenever we speak information, it always includes these two. The information which flows from the supplier to the customer and from customer back to the vendor. One second.
I'm sorry for the disturbance.
Yeah.
So whenever we speak about this flow of information, so here whenever we tell flow of information, this flow of information not only from the both side, but both the types of information, that is all the information that has to be passed on from the supplier to the vendor, and also all such information that has to be passed from the customer to the vendors. And we tend to call it as upstream and downstream. Now, the downstream flow of information has important components like, you know, capacity estimates for plants, or the stocks available, or the dispatch advice, and stock transfer notes. Or it also includes warranties, quality assurance. While the upstream components of the information flows are inputs for forecast, marketing plans, or dispatch plans, or it could be production plans and procurement plans. And also, it involves, you know, orders from customer and dealers, quality, feedback, all such things are also included in upstream. So, as you said, upstream and downstream, whatever is flowed through is downstream, whatever is flowed back is upstream information. Now, the last one here is funds. So, what about these funds? Now, funds are the ones which ultimately makes sense to any supply chain or any business activity. Now, funds, it represents the commercial part of supply chain. And remember one thing, funds, it always runs in the opposite to the direction of the value flow. That is, now the product or the value for the products or the product or service, it flows from the raw material supplier to the ultimate consumer. Whereas funds flow in the opposite direction. It starts moving from the ultimate consumer to the last person in the upstream. And funds, when we tell in simple words, it reflects the money which is paid in respect to that of transfer of, title and or for rendering service delivery. And, in cash flow, there are also some other things such as credit periods, or sometimes there also can be advances for payments from customers or dealers or the vendors who are there within it. Now, the cash flow determines how the value flow is financed by the various actors who are there in the supply chain. Now it is already 12:46, and if I start with the supply chain effectiveness, maybe I will not be able to tell about it. So we shall directly see the supply chain macro process in a firm. So, or will you be confused if you go through this? So what we can probably do is, maybe we shall see the rest in the coming class. So now I want to ask question.